Well, Hoos, we are in Scott Stadium on this Thursday night for the last home game of the 2012 season. Unfortunately, the Hoos came up short against UNC, letting all hopes of bowl eligibility go out the window.
You know, North Carolina is a very good team. They played well. They had a good scheme, you know, for us, and they executed well, and we did not.
I don't ever think that as a team we're just going to let things go downhill. I think we got better character than that as a team. So that never crossed my mind that the game was just going to go downhill. It just seemed to happen. I mean, I can't point the one thing to say this is why it went downhill, but it just did. And it happened in a hurry. You looked up and the score was out of hand. So, it's just one of those things you kind of like, how did this just happen like that? And I think that's what a lot of guys were just thinking, but not the way we pictured the night going.
While the Hoos kept it close until about halftime, a series of offensive mistakes and special teams blunders allowed the Tar Heels to run away with the game. Kevin Parks came up short on a 4th-and-1 for a touchdown, and then later Darius Jennings dropped an easy pass from quarterback Phillip Sims, which would have been a guaranteed touchdown.
I really didn't have any thoughts going through my mind at the time. Kind of unbelievable. It's just the way the game went for us tonight. We didn't connect on a few plays like that.
Very disappointing. You get down to that situation there, we have a chance to tie the score. Seemed like the game kind of turned on that. Not getting that fourth down opportunity. Then, as it went on, there were other fourth down opportunities at the other end that we didn't get. Them driving the ball and not being able to stop them, particularly with the bubble screens and kind of the play action passes they were doing. Couldn't quite, get a rhythm to stop them. Thought we played very competitive in the first half and had a chance to, we left some points on the field for sure. Drop pass by DJ, wide open. It's frustrating. I mean, it is. It's frustrating. I feel for the guys in the locker room there, but we give North Carolina credit. They played a good offense. It's a good team. They played well.
They got a couple of good breaks, honestly. They got a couple of good breaks. Things just went their way tonight.
As I mentioned earlier, this does mean that the Hoos are no longer in the running for bowl eligibility. Of course, this has players frustrated and a little bit down that the seniors weren't able to come away with a win on senior night to continue that run, but they do head to Blacksburg next week to play the Hokies, and they're going to treat this as their bowl game, which keeps the players' spirits alive and ready to fight next week.
It's Tech. It gets no bigger than that for UVA and Tech. You need no picking up for that. If you can't get ready to play against Tech, you need to be somewhere else, for real. That's just my personal opinion. This is one of the biggest rivalries in college football.
Well, you tell them that there's one more game left. There's one more opportunity. And you always like for your guys to have a positive college playing experience. One more opportunity to have play with your teammates and play your rival, your in-state rival, and you have to make it your bowl game, basically. That's what it is, one last game to play. So I think the players would be up to the challenge. And it's a very quiet locker room in there with a lot of disappointments, but we just got to pick ourselves up and get ready to play our last football game.
Yeah, it's tough for especially the seniors and the young guys knowing that we're not going to get our seniors to a bowl game this year, but we got a big one next week in Virginia Tech, and we're going to prepare just like we always do and try to get a win next week.
I will be traveling to Virginia Tech next weekend to bring all of you information from that game, but just as it was senior night for the Hoos on the football team in Scott Stadium, it is also my last broadcast to you from Scott Stadium. I want to thank all of you for hanging out with me throughout the season, but I hope you don't disappear. I'll have plenty of basketball information for you in the coming weeks. So for the last time from Scott Stadium, for Sabre TV, I'm Miranda Mason.
Oh, man, it's a lot of emotions. I love Scott Stadium. I love, the fans. I love just the energy, everyone brings. I love the team. So it's disappointing. It hurts, honestly. You're putting so much work, you're putting so much effort, all the guys collectively, You know, when everyone has worked, you know, extremely hard to reach a goal, and you know, you come up short. But you know, like I tell the young guys, man, you just gotta value, just value the game and value what it gives you. It gives you an opportunity to just do something you love. So I mean, whenever you step on the field, that's how you gotta approach it. Just enjoying the game you love. But I just appreciate everybody, all the fans, just the program. It's been amazing.